turn that shit up, man. Quick video. Ain't gonna be too long. I got this shadow all in my face. But woke up, got word. Knicks made a move. I think the Knicks are like the first team to really make a move before the trade deadline. But yeah, Porzingis is heading to Dallas with Courtney Lee and Tim Hardaway. I didn't think that was bad. You know what I mean? They picked up three vets. You know what I'm saying? Mavericks gave away Dennis Smith Jr. You know what I'm saying? Wesley and who else that was? Dennis Smith Jr., Wesley, and DeAndre Jordan. You know what I'm saying? So, you look at it, bro. The Knicks are trying to set up their team for a veteran presence for, like, you know, a big time name to come in, like a KD, Kyrie Irving, somebody. You know what I'm saying? They're making room for somebody. Even with these pickups, do I think the Knicks are going to be really good with a KD? No. They're going to be a good team. Yeah. And if you look at the rankings, they're the worst team in the league right now. You know what I'm saying? Phoenix is up one game. Phoenix has 11 wins. The Knicks has 10 wins. The Mavericks, on the other hand, are still in contention for the eighth spot. So, picking up Tim Hardaway, you know, really good shooter. That kind of replaces the whole Wesley Matthews trade. Courtney Lee's decent. But Porzingis still out. You know what I'm saying? So, it's kind of like, okay, you want him and Luka to... You know what I'm saying? I guess they're gonna try to see if Porzingis can be the new Dirk Nowitzki, because Luka's a beast. Luka, like, he doesn't even remind you of Dirk. Like, Luka goes behind the back, dunks on y'all type of stuff. Dirk was never that kind of player. He was always a fadeaway finesse. You know what I'm saying? Shooter. Yeah, he was able to shoot over people. He was doing what KD was doing before. You know what I'm saying? He was doing it before KD was even doing it. You know what I'm saying? Just purely fading away, shooting over people. Mid-range, shooting over people. Three-pointer, pulling up. Shooting over people. I'm 7-something foot. I'm gonna shoot over you, period. You know what I'm saying? So, honestly, the move wasn't bad for neither team. Because, you know what I'm saying? Porzingis is a beast, and he's an all-star. So, once he comes back, it's not going to be... You know what I mean? It's not going to be a bad trade. You know what I'm saying? But then... The Knicks have a chance of landing someone like R.J. Barrett, Zion Williamson. You know what I'm saying? You never know what these teams are going to try to pick. I'm a Zion Williamson first pick type person because he's box office. And the kid, if you watch the kid's efficient. He might take 15 shots and make 12. Might take 12 and make 9. The kid's efficient. I love his game. You know, there's always room to grow, but hell, he can always develop that jump shot. But, you know what I'm saying? Like Blake Griffin, for example. That's how I kind of look at Zion, like a Blake Griffin. You know? Athletic, big, can jump over people. Stronger than a lot of cats. You know what I'm saying? But just got to develop that jump shot. And it came with Blake Griffin in time. It'll come with Zion Williamson also. But other than that, bro, I'll give this trade right here. I want to say a C+, B-, because... I understand Porzingis wanted to get out, but, you know, what makes you think he's going to sign back to the Mavericks? Like, you know what I'm saying? Luka? That's it? I don't know, bro. Dallas has always been one of those wild, out-of-space teams that you just never know what the fuck you're going to get because Mark Cuban, I don't know. They haven't been good since that championship run, so I don't know what the fuck to think about that. And you think about it, you wasted a first-round pick because you could have got somebody else for Dennis Smith. I don't know, bro. Y'all get in my comment section. Let me know what y'all think, man. It's your boy T. Hills, man. And I am gone.